Hey you guys, welcome back to my channel. It's Mandy from Mandy's World and I'm here with you guys. First of all, y'all, first thing I want to say is I went live this morning, y'all. I did. Y'all need to peep my live. When y'all see me live clicking, because it be lit, y'all. It be lit, okay? I'm not joking with you. I'm telling you, okay? But on a more serious note, you guys. Something that I want to talk to you guys and girls, like, but this is just right now, this is girl talk. Right now, I am directing this at my sister girls because I came across a situation which caused me to have to be in this predicament to where I'm talking to you guys about this. I already vented and got it off my chest again. And it's really the same person is the root of all the evil. But I do think that it's over. Completely over today. Like, I think our whole situation is done. I don't know. Yeah. But, okay. Now, the point of this video is to talk about. And it's so hard because women, first of all, it should be duly noted that I'm a Capricorn. And if you ever researched Capricorns, we are nurturers, caterers. We meet people and then we want to do the most for them. We're giving, we're loving, we're generous. That's just the type of people we are. So when we come across people who have never had this type of treatment, they can use you. They can use you to benefit them and then cast you to the side. And I know this, I've dealt with this all my life, and it still does not stop me from being the nicest, best person I could be. You get what I'm saying? Like, I don't even know how to make it sound any, I don't even know, because I'm not an expert, but this part, I'm an expert on. Okay, ladies. Don't chase a man. Don't chase. Okay? If he ain't calling you back, he's making his point clear. If he not texting you, you don't have to call. You don't have to text him 99,000 times, 2 soliloquies, 1 poem. He see that, sis. The text going through, he see that he's ignoring you. He's ignoring you, okay? So you could be, and for some reason with men, well, I'm not gonna say for some reason, we already know why, because it's his role. You're stepping into his role by chasing him. His job is to chase you, to call you, to pursue you, because that's why men are conquerors, okay? Even once he gets you and you know deep down in your heart that he's got you and you really like him and, you know, you're willing to make it to the next level, still give him something to work for. Men do better by reward, okay? They do better by reward, okay? You have to have expectations or goals for them to reach. They work better that way. You know, you ever notice if you give him something to do, he gonna get out there and if he got to cut the grass, he gonna get out there. Cut the grass, friend, pick up the leaves. He gonna edge the walkway because they do better with things to do. Now, that does not mean that you can't do anything for him. You know what I mean? But it's like you have to know when to do it. You know? Like when he's doing so much, being sweet, being kind, thinking about you, you know, always getting dinner, always doing this, always doing that, stopping at your job, checking on you. Sometimes you have to do one thing, make lunch for him and bring it to his job or something like that, you know. But don't be that go-to girl. Don't be that go-to girl. When you're that go-to girl, guess what's gonna happen? He always gonna go off, do whatever he do, and then run back to you to save the day. After you save the day, he's gonna get back up and he's gonna forget and he's gonna run back off. It's gonna be a cycle, a never-ending cycle. And then you're gonna keep feeling unfulfilled. You're gonna keep feeling left behind. You're gonna keep trying to figure out what it is you have to do to make this person treat you the way that you deserve to be treated. Now, I will say this, and I'm guilty of it. I'm so guilty of it. We sometimes tend to pick the wrong type of men. We do. People like me, well, you know what they say? They say that most women pick men that are like their dads. And I kind of can see that. Especially in my situation. Most of the men I've ever dated was like my dad. And I didn't even know my dad. But from what I hear about him and how he used to be, the dudes that I date always have that same characteristic. Not to mention the fact that I do date younger men. So a lot of times they're not even mature enough to know how to treat a woman. You know what I'm saying? Which is understandable because it's not like I'm trying to get anything more, but mutual respect. You don't have to be old to know how to mutually respect somebody or treat somebody like you want to be treated. So that age is out the window. That has nothing to do with it. Okay. What really has to do with it is the good guy and the bad guy. The good guy and the bad guy. The good guy may not be as attractive as you would like or your type. Because I always say I have a type. I do have a type. It's a guy that I do always pick. Kind of, sort of. At first, I never used to have a type. All the guys I used to date were always totally opposite. You know, like, I would date one guy, and then the next guy would look nothing like him. I used to not have a type. But now I could say I have a type. 6 feet or taller. I love hair, a lot of hair, whether it's dreads or their own hair. Beard. Light brown to chocolate. I have a type. So, but the thing about it is with types, the more handsome guy, and I don't want to offend those that think you're handsome. I don't want to offend you if you think you're cute, but the most handsome guys most of the time are jerks. They're the bad guy, like, because they have options. You know what I mean? Like, people that have options don't put you first on the list. People that feel like they have plenty of options, they can take you or leave you. They don't have, especially if they weren't raised in a home where there was a monogamous relationship or any example of a good relationship, healthy relationship, they already don't know how to treat you. They already don't know, okay? Then if you add into the fact that they may be doing other things like they never finished college. They probably didn't finish high school. And I'm not judging those people either because I didn't finish high school. I had to go back and get my GED, so I'm not judging. But what I'm saying is people that accomplish goals, life expectancies, like they have more of a, okay, we're going to put it like this so that I'm not offending nobody. The something to lose people. There are people with nothing to lose, i.e. drug dealers, scammers, thieves, robbers, burglars. Like, those type of dudes don't have none to lose, sis. So, it's been times where they've been in the prison or wherever for 5 or 10 years, 4, 3 years. So, they've been alone. They know how to operate alone. Then they find women who don't like to be alone. And I'm all right with saying, okay, low self-esteem. It's self-esteem. You have to be woman enough to admit that there's a self-esteem issue. There's got to be a self-esteem issue, an abandonment issue that's causing you to allow people into your life that are not good for you, that you see it. You see it ahead of time. Like, you see that, okay, this is probably not going to go anywhere. Yeah, it's fun. Yeah, it's exciting. Yeah, he's cute. Yeah, the sex is great. But this is probably not going to go anywhere. Like, we're probably not gonna become husband and wife. We definitely probably not gonna even have a relationship. But to not be able to say, I'm not gonna deal with that, is a problem. That's when you have to do some self-reflection. That's when you have to think about who you're choosing. You know what I'm saying? Like, well, it's not him, it's you. It's not him. He's finding you because you have that on your forehead. A sucker on your forehead. And I know it hurts. It hurts me because after the situation with this person, this whole situation, it's like, I've been a sucker the whole time. I've been a sucker the whole time. I did like him. I pursued him. I got him. I threw him away. Then I got him back. Because I wasn't ever happy. Like, you shouldn't have to force nobody to give you attention, to treat you like a woman, to want to be around you, to want to talk to you. Like, and sometimes, I ain't gonna lie, sometimes guys use that as a control thing. Sometimes it is a control thing. It's nothing, sometimes that's how, but it goes back to the type of dude you're dealing with. Goes back to the type of dude you're dealing with. Okay, ladies? So, I mean, the moral of the story is, have some self-reflection. And these next couple of days, I think that's what I'm... And I'm probably going to give a story time about it. I haven't decided yet because, you know, me and him, we just keep on keeping on with this crazy shit. And I don't even know if I'm prepared to talk about it right now. But, yeah. It's the type of dude. So, my advice, ladies, would be to... So have a moment of self-reflection. Look at the type of dudes you've been allowing into your life. Deal with those abandonment issues. If your dad left, if he passed away, if you never had him, you know. Understand that it's okay. Because those feelings of rejection, they're normal. They're healthy. I know, you know. I was like... It goes back deep. You know, you have to dig deep, and it goes back deep into the childhood and, you know, how you grew up and what you experienced, and that causes you to pick the people that you pick. What you saw causes you to pick the people that you pick. You know what I'm saying? But at the end of the day, you know what feels good and you know what does not feel good. Honestly, are you going to keep choosing what does not feel good, or are you going to try something new? So now I'm thinking that since this is the beginning of April, I'm going to start giving the good guy a chance. And I'm challenging you, ladies, to the same thing. I'm challenging you to giving the good guy a chance. I know you think you're going to be bored and white bread melancholy, but you never know. You never know, sis. And guess what? He wants to call you. He wants to take you out. He wants to rub your feet. He wants to give you a massage. He wants to check on you during the day. He wants to FaceTime. He wants to do all of that. He does. And he's looking for the right lady to give that kind of attention to. But nobody ever gives him a chance. He's always the best friend that you talk about that nigga with. We're gonna stop. 2020, we're going to stop. Because you know what? People treat you like you allow them to treat you. So I figure if every woman put their foot down and not allow men to treat them like trash, they're going to have to change. They're going to have to, or they're going to be alone. Period. So y'all, I'm challenging you to this. Let's make them change. Let's see if 2020, we can change them with what we allow. And hey, worst thing, worse, it don't work. They don't change and they stay the same, because a lot of times people don't change unless they really have a good reason. Or you actually find somebody clearly and truly interested in you that'll treat you the way you want to be treated. So you guys, I just wanted to stop in and say that. If you are not subscribed, please go ahead and hit that subscribe button and smash that notification bell so that you know the next time I upload. Hit me with a like. And definitely, you guys, leave a comment down below. If you have any suggestions, let me know. Or if you were like me, the type that liked the bad boys but found you a good guy, let us know in the comments. Thank you, Mandy Gang. Enjoy the rest of your day. Bye.